everyone, Steve Accardo here from the Raffer Report, and I'm with rapper from New York City, 2-Tone. So, I understand that you just came out with a new mixtape, The Anomaly. Can you explain kind of the writing process behind it?
Basically, you know, I just came out with The Anomaly. It dropped March 8th. It's 13 tracks. I'm rapping on all the tracks. I got one feature. Shout out to Justin, aka Mr. Falsetto. He sang on Anthem. It's produced entirely by Audio Games. Shout out to Audio Games. And basically, the whole process was just me writing anything that was different.
Yeah.
Because The Anomaly is just anything that deviates from a set pattern. So it was just any inspiration I was feeling, I wasn't trying to be like confined to a box. And it was created over the course of like a year to a year and a half. Because I didn't just sit and just write the whole thing.
Yeah.
It was like, all right, I'm really feeling this track, and then I wrote to that, and then other tracks, I liked the beat, but I didn't return to it for like a year later.
Yeah.
But it came out, I don't know how, it came out really good, and you know, it's definitely something that y'all should check out.
Definitely.
Yeah.
No, I heard it myself, and I have to agree, it's an awesome mixtape. Now, you just had a show too at Muldoon's the other week, you know,
yeah.
You want to describe how that went?
I had the show last Thursday. Shout out to Al for hooking up the show. Big Al, as he's known around here. And it was a great show. I think it was like 5,200 people. Like, they wasn't all there to see me, although I would have liked for it to be like that. But, you know, people were at the bar, and then people were like, you know, right up on the stage. But it was just like a real cool atmosphere.
That's cool.
It was, I think it was like 30 minutes. And I did songs from The Anomaly, and then in between the songs, I did like some freestyles.
Nice.
So just to keep people into what we were doing.
Yeah.
And it was like, there was never any silence. So when my song finished, it would go to an instrumental.
Nice.
And then either I talk over it or I would freestyle. So the crowd was like always into it, you know. And then I'm just doing stupid stuff on stage.
That's the way, yeah.
So
keep the crowd
in. It was a good show, yeah.
For sure.
Very good show. Thank you if you came out.
So was it kind of like the New York City shows, or not really along the same level as those, I would imagine?
To be honest, I've only played one show in New York City.
Yeah.
And to be honest, it was like a similar bar, but it was actually a little bit smaller.
Really?
Yeah.
Was there like a lot of people in there though? Was it packed or?
It wasn't packed. Like it was an event that my friend was doing.
Nice.
And you know, I was helping them out. It was a charity event.
Okay.
So you know, that's it was actually cool. Less people. Yeah, it was a great cause. But it was less people, and I want to do more shows. So ask me
Definitely.
That in a couple of months, and maybe I'll be able
sure
to tell you.
Yeah. I'll be sure to. So what's going on in the future for 2-Tone? Any new material or upcoming shows we can start looking forward to?
I just released this project. So what I'm thinking about doing is releasing a bunch of EPs.
Yeah.
Because, like, after doing the album, you know, it takes a lot of time. You know, there's a lot of production, a lot of writing that goes into it. And it's probably between, like, 13 to 18 tracks for a project. So the EP, you can do it between, like, 5 to 8 or 5 to 10. No more than 10. So I'm thinking about doing 3 to 4 5-song EPs.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of having the same theme, like, each EP is going to be a different chapter. So, like, but it'll each have a different sound.
Oh,
you
cool.
get what I mean? So it's like each one is its own little experiment, and then just release them at different times.
That's a really cool idea, actually.
Thank you. So yes, it's stuff on the horizon. Something else with Audio Games. Something else with Mr. OK. Either called The Intermission. It's a working title. We'll see what happens. And just a compilation of other instrumentals that I'm
feeling. Sounds good.
Yeah.
So I know you want to do kind of showcase your talents a little bit.
I got a little bit of talent.
Kind of go with the verse. I can't do much with beatboxing, so I don't know how that's going
right.
to go.
That's all right,
might
man.
Have to just go straight a cappella.
Yeah, I can do a cappella. This is from the self-titled track of the album called The Anomaly.
Okay.
Hello, world. It goes like, I found the remedy better, yet the remedy found me, helping me see a brighter shade so that I could upgrade. And honestly, that turned me into an anomaly so I could set my sights high, just like astronomy. It ain't hard, I just read the signs like astrology, make my mind move kinda like a prodigy. Honestly, who as hot as me? Intricate as physiology, I scheme diabolically. Same thing that made me grow, hold me back. Ironically, I got a condition, spitting ill flows chronically. $1 million man like I was engineered bionically. I'm mixed like gin and tonic B. Mixed emotions, mixed feelings. I'm just playing my hand, you can blame the dealer. Trying to figure out what's realer. Looking for a shot of success, but I settle for tequila. It ain't gonna stop me. So that's a little sample.
It's just a taste, guys. Definitely something to check out. So we're also going to play another song off of that, too. If you want to go put a spot for that, the song we're going to roll right after this.
The song we're going to roll is called Lola. This is the single off the album The Anomaly, and you can catch it on Bandcamp. If you want to find me on Google, search me. 2-Tone, the number 2, D-A-S-H-T-O-N-E. 2-Tone.
All right, Steve Accardo from The Ralphie Report. 2-Tone.
Yeah, no.
Take it easy, guys.
I always get it. So, give it to me. Yeah, that right. Let's go. I always get what I want and I want you. The things you heard about me, it's probably so true. I'm so uncouth in and out the booth, but I can't tell a lie. See, you know I'm telling the truth. The way I'm spitting, yo, call it dragon flow. 5,000 degrees, I burn the studio. I could direct you to my bedroom like a movie roll. 30 minutes later, now we kissing like a mistletoe. Put you on the table, now I guess I'm on my kitchen floor. And by the time we finish, we'll be on the kitchen floor. I help you remember some tricks that you used to know. That's what it's made for.